Welcome to your Wednesday. Let's get some of this order of business out of the way. Upper 90s right now in Grand Junction, triple digits for Delta, low 90s at Montrose. These are the current temperatures. Now, highs for the day, just about official. Grand Junction, again, parked at 99 degrees. Delta, again, parked at the 100 degree mark. Montrose, mid 90s when we're supposed to be the upper 80s. So everybody on the board today going a little bit warmer than the averages by several degrees. Tomorrow afternoon, we'll just go slightly warmer than the average by only a couple of degrees. And then the closer to the weekend we get, through the weekend and into next week, we'll get those temperatures back to the averages, which is basically low 90s for Grand Junction, mid 80s for Montrose. So yeah, we'll expect better temperatures. But with that, we also have the increase of cloud coverage and storms spreading through the region. Wind speeds right now, 5, maybe 15 miles per hour. Top wind gusts of the day. I show these now because between 10 and 20 miles per hour is about where we've been today in the Tri-County area, but I still think we have the opportunity to blast these up to the 25 and to the 35 mile per hour zone just this evening. In fact, by 10 o'clock, we should have realized stronger wind gusts. We could possibly double these numbers you see right here because we do have storms moving through the area. Also, with those storms pulsing through the area, we now have a flash flood watch for the Grizzly Creek burn scar. Goes until 10 p.m. tonight. Likely we will see this again Thursday, even through the course of the weekend. So pay close attention to not just our website, but if you can't, also try cotrip.org because they're going to give you the latest information. Of course, I'll be doing Facebook Lives once I hear about the watch and the subsequent warning and then the safety closure. It's a possibility. We're back in that monsoon pattern where we're getting a lot of showers and thunderstorms. We're getting some light rain right now up on the Grand Mesa. That's a little bit higher in elevation than the valley floor for the Grand Valley. But you can see dark clouds have kind of just popped up. Now, we've been watching these clouds all day develop. Most of the storms right now, and you can see the Grand Mesa right there, most of the storms right now have started over the mountain zones. Somewhat of an anchor. There is some slow movement. That in and of itself creates a problem for flooding concerns over steep grade, over saturated soils, over burn scars, and we've just about experienced that in many locations. Different today than yesterday, the Durango Cortez area, they had showers and thunderstorms moving through at this hour. Now, not so much, really just the San Juan Mountains and only a couple of little cells at that. Earlier this afternoon, and you just probably missed that orange box, the Colorado-Utah border, Mesa County, went under a severe thunderstorm warning briefly just before the 5 o'clock hour. So your smart device probably alerted you to that. A severe thunderstorm warning, radar indicated hail and strong wind and heavy downpours. That's an unpopulated rural area. Unfortunately, the entire Mesa County region picked up that alert. So a quick explainer, that's just the way it is. And some things won't change with that information. There's that cloud up on the Grand Mesa, and there's some lightning strikes, so hopefully you're not up mushroom hunting right now. That's something you should do between sunrise and noon, and then get down out of the elevation. Even if you're hiking, get down from elevation by the midday because storms are gonna pop. I do expect more storms to move through the Grand Valley tonight. That'll increase our wind speeds. That'll put some rain down, and of course, lightning is a concern, and that could be a wildfire igniter. Looking at Delta County, same situation. Some of our mountain communities already settling down with some dark clouds, some light rain. These are going to continue moving through the Uncompahgre Valley tonight as well. We're not going to have a late night with these storms. The possibility exists for that best Thursday night into Friday morning. Montrose County, quiet for now, but we getting storms coming at us from the east to west direction, except for around the northern zones. Craig, Rangeley, Meeker, these storms are moving even slower, 5 miles per hour, except they're going southbound. Now, the reason why they're southbound is because most of the storm motion is occurring on the southern edge of our high pressure system. Craig, Rangeley, Meeker, a little bit too far to the north to really get affected by that, but we're going to continue experiencing this particular pattern with our high pressure system in the next couple of days, slowly migrating to the east. Now, yesterday I talked about the possibility of this not tracking eastbound, actually halting and then swinging back this weekend over the western zones, and that would heat us up and dry us out. But it looks like we're holding steady. It looks like we're going to continue tracking eastbound. So storms will continue migrating in, and that's going to be just about every afternoon, not just through this weekend, but even into the middle and beginning of next week, where we should get some more intense storms. So August is going to continue with this rain pattern. The next couple of afternoons for Grand Junction, wrapping up the work week, afternoon storms, yes, late night, That goes into Friday morning. But our temperatures should be closer to the averages for this time of the year. Late weekend and early next week, that's when we fall below our afternoon averages. But that should coincide with a more robust storm pattern. In the meantime, it's just isolated storms each and every afternoon. A little bit here, a little bit there, so that everyone at least gets a shot at getting some rain showers for the next handful of days.